Alrighty, welcome back to the Morning Drill. It is 8:05 on this Monday morning, a couple days before Christmas, and I think we're going to get a white Christmas. We're going to check that weather forecast in case you're just joining us. We'll check that coming up in just a little bit. But first, this morning, this is very exciting because we've been working on this for like 3 or 4 years now, getting Ryan Sampson into the studio here this morning, and we got him! Yeah! Hey, Ryan's joining us from Sirius XM's Hits One channel.
That's right. It's good to be here finally. You know, I love what you do. I watch you all the time when I'm doing my show. I kind of got you on in the corner paying attention to that too.
That's cool. So listen, there's like a million questions, but let's start with the basics.
Okay.
And you know, here you are. You grew up in Titusville.
Right.
How'd you get involved in broadcasting?
I wanted to do it. You know what? That little window they used to have at WTIV was really what made it. When I was a kid and I drove by and I could see somebody talking on the radio and hearing it at the same time, I just thought that was the coolest thing in the world. And I always wanted to do it. And somehow I got lucky enough to do it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, who did you listen to growing up?
You know what? That's the thing is I do top 40 now, but around here there really wasn't a pop station. It was a lot of country. There was a lot of rock. And I never heard the format that I did until I went away to college. And now, you know, I'm immersed in it and I do it all the time.
Yeah.
But, you know,
did you listen to like Tim Nelson and those guys?
Absolutely.
Back then?
Yeah, absolutely. Everyone that was here, I definitely listened to because that's what I had. But once I started going out, there were people, and I'm lucky enough now, my boss is actually one guy that I used to listen to. His name is Kid Kelly.
Really?
Yeah. So,
wow.
Yeah. So now that I work for, you know, a guy that I kind of idolized when I grew up, and now he's my boss who kicks my butt every day. It's kind of
awesome.
Nice. Yeah.
This is another question, but a shocking death over the summer of Kid Craddock.
Yeah, that was really sad. I've known people that worked for Kid, and he was a really genuine guy who did a lot of things for his community down in Dallas or wherever he was. And it was so sudden, and you know. His staff too were, you know, they were such a great group, and it's very unfortunate.
You got involved in radio in high school here?
Yes, I was my senior year in high school is when I started on WTIV.
So who were some of the personalities you worked with?
It would have been I remember Daryl Edwards was
Daryl, yeah.
Yeah, was there back then.
Daryl was on his way out when I started at TIV.
Okay.
And it's like he disappeared, and they found him doing overnights on Classy 100 in Erie.
Yeah. And he was great. He, you know, he taught me a lot. I used to fill in for him on the afternoons. But it was, you know, it was kind of a bare bones operation back then.
Yeah. And you start thinking about some of these personalities, Mark, who were on the radio back then. I mean, you had not only Tim Nelson, but you had Jim Gross. You had Daryl, you had Jeff Sterling.
I mean,
there was all these names.
Yeah, Jeff is one of the guys that trained me there. I worked with Jeff a lot.
He trained me.
Yeah.
So that's scary, though. No, great guy. He just moved back to Titusville.
Okay.
So, what were you doing? Afternoons? Were you just filling in, doing board hopping stuff at the time?
Pretty much. I was the Sunday morning church broadcast shift. So I went in at 6 a.m. and would fire the transmitter up and would, you know, play all the broadcasts, the church broadcasts until noon when I got to read the news, and I would screw it up every week.
How many times did Bob Sauber call you up?
A few. There was pretty much, if you don't know what you're doing, you don't belong here. And I deserved it a few of those times. Most definitely.
That could be a book in itself. All the great sayings from the Saubers.
Yeah. If you don't know what you're doing, you don't belong there.
Yeah.
Well, the thing that I always loved about, which it's kind of a little, you know, radio inside thing, is that the control console that they had, it was an old one. I think it was the original one from the station when they put it on. So when you would come in every week, it was different. They had routed the different things, and you would touch it and get a good electrical jolt.
Yeah,
and it was almost dodging bullets working there.
Oh yeah, and I always hated this time of year, the static. You know, you get shocked off at everything.
Well, the most fun is remember they used to get some of the programming via satellite, and one of the first things I had to do there was the satellite got covered in snow, and I thought I was going to be on the radio, and the next thing you know, in a foot of snow, I'm on a ladder on a roof clearing a satellite.
Like, yeah, keep in mind, high school kids doing
exactly.
This.
This isn't what I signed up for.
Yeah, and you know, the cool thing was that the Saubers opened the door for high school kids to come in and learn. And if you think about it, and I know you probably thought, I thought this, you know, other kids were doing all these other odd jobs.
Yeah.
And it seemed like jobs, like they were working hard.
We weren't working.
No, but we were having a blast.
Yeah, absolutely.
Having a blast. No, those kids may be laying pipe with Charter or Oil Creek, maybe, you know, they were rolling in some cash, but
yeah. We were having fun.
Yeah,
yeah. I really enjoyed my time there. You know, it was short, but it gave me a huge advantage because when I went to college, like you said, to get the high school kids involved, I was one of the very few people that when I got to college had already had experience doing it. Mm-hmm. So I was, you know, slightly ahead of everybody else because of that.
Did you think when you were taking those college classes, like, oh, wait a second, this isn't how it really works, or?
A little bit, yeah. And I recognize that. So I wasn't an academic type. I was there for 4 years, but I wasn't, you know, maybe went to class.
Yeah,
I was there.
I volunteered for a 3-hour shift at the radio station at Edinburgh. I was on the air for 3 hours. The professor walked in and said, "Oh, you sound pretty good. Have you ever done this before?" I was like, "Yeah." But the experience of going from, you know, a real station to the college, it was horrifying for me.
Yeah.
Because it just wasn't right.
Right.
And I just said, I'm done after this.
Yeah.
And then I focused on, you know, I was commuting, so I just really dove into helping out, you know, Sabra's other stations.
Sure.
So, but, you know, think about these names. Yourself.
Uh-huh.
Eric Reinhart.
Yes.
You had Litzinger.
That's right. Yeah. Who's still out there working today.
Yeah. We'll hear him once in a while, you know, doing a report for... what's his name? I can't think of his name. Anyways, he does a lot of reports. Yeah.
You know, I think, and I could be wrong about this, but I think that Sam Litzinger and I actually had the same bedroom as a child, which is even more of a coincidence.
Really?
I believe my parents bought their first house from his parents.
That is cool. Yeah. So something That's about perfect. The house.
Yeah. And on Enterprise Road, out in Enterprise.
Did you ever talk to Sam? He's
in
D.C.
No, I've actually never met him.
Really?
I would really like to one day, but I've never met him.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, write a book.
All the time we hear his voice, you know.
Yeah. He's always, because I remember, you know, that was when I was on WTIV. He was, I believe, working for Mutual Radio then, which was a syndicated news thing.
Yeah.
And he was one of the main anchors. So I was sitting in the chair at WTIV, and that's kind of always what I look for. I'm like, if this guy sat in this chair and got there, there's no reason why I couldn't do it, too.
Yeah. All right. So you went to school where? Syracuse?
Syracuse. Yeah.
Wow. What a great opportunity.
The SI Newhouse School of Public Communication, which is considered to be really good, I was not in. I was a history major. They had a spelling, grammar, and punctuation test, which everybody has to take. I'm slightly dyslexic, and it was a multiple choice spelling test. I was never going to pass it. So I was a history student, and I just worked. I, you know, had jobs on the side and learned that way.
Wow. Then you stayed up in that area on the radio, or did you?
Yeah, I was in Syracuse. I worked at a top 40 station in Syracuse on Hot 107.9.
Where, by the way, Ryan Eggleston, I think, interned there.
I got him that job.
You got him that job,
I got him that job. He was there for a long time. And I did overnights, and then I had 13 credits left in my last semester. And I got a call from a radio station in Baltimore, and they're like, "Come do nights." And I said, "Okay, bye, Syracuse." And so I still have 13 credits of college, one day to finish.
That's great. That's great. Now, did you go by Hawaiian Ryan up
there?
Yeah,
when I was in Syracuse, I used Ryan Sampson. And we had a new program director that comes in, which generally means you're going to get fired. When you get a new boss, you probably can expect that he wants his friends to be there. But instead, he just changed all our names. My best friend, his name was Chris, and he made him be Bananas Foster, which just, you know, these awful radio names. And he told me that I was going to have to be Flying Ryan, and I refused. I'm like, I'll never be Flying Ryan. It's never going to happen. But I always wore Hawaiian shirts, and I eventually agreed on Hawaiian Ryan, which lasted for a long time. I worked after Syracuse. I was in Baltimore for 4 years and used that, too.
Very nice. I think when I was on Froggy, I was Ted Hopple.
Yeah, the Froggy stations always have those great names.
Yeah. So then you went to Baltimore?
Yes.
How long were you there?
I was there for 4 years. I worked at the Top 40 in Baltimore. I did nights there and then moved over to a hot AC station and was the music director and nights there.
Wow.
Yeah.
And then what?
And then was Lincoln, Nebraska.
That really?
Was, yeah, that was...
How did you get to Nebraska?
Well, I asked myself that, too. And at the time, I wanted, you know, I was the music director, and I wanted to be the program director. I wanted to be in charge of a station. And I was sending out demos and tapes everywhere and getting no response. And finally, I got a call. I sent one off at like midnight. 9 a.m. the next morning, they called me back. And they're like, come work here. And I ignored them. I'm like, Lincoln, Nebraska, that's never going to happen. And a couple days later, they called me back. And sure enough, I went out there. And I liked it. It was an old boss of mine that I had no idea was there. And wow. He didn't know I was coming for the interview. So when we saw each other, it just worked.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So how long were you there?
A year and a half. I was there for 18 months. And then that's when I came to Sirius.
Okay, now, was that something that you pursued, or did they contact you?
They contacted me. Rich, who ate my co-host on the mashup now, him and I worked together in Syracuse. And he was taking another job within Sirius and called me and said, do you want my old job? And I said, yes. And it was about a year after that him and I started doing the morning mashup.
Wow, that's incredible. So what was that experience like, going from Lincoln, Nebraska to the big city?
It was a party. It was I was so happy to do that. The people in Nebraska were really nice. I met some really great friends there. But at the same time, it was I think this place is more exciting.
Yeah, well, you go from Syracuse to Baltimore to Nebraska and then now to New York City. Here you are, the Big Apple. Lots to do and a lot of people to see. You've interviewed hundreds of actors, uh-huh. musicians. Who are some of the big ones that stand out in your mind?
Lady Gaga is always fun. She always has great stories. She's really nice. We do a lot, and someone who's really good to us, and we just did an episode for the Food Network with Guy Fieri on Guy's Big Bite, and he was in last week, and he's one guy that, is a really good guy who loves to help people out, makes great food, and he brings us chicken wings for breakfast.
Oh, wow.
every couple of weeks.
That's great.
Which we like. So Guy's always fun. And this is really, I hate saying this, but it's kind of almost so routine some days that I forget who was there, and I have to go back and look at pictures because it's just, when you go to work today, you kind of get, okay, you're talking to this person, and when you do that for a few years, they all blend together in a way.
You might not be able to say this, but is there somebody who comes in that you guys just dread to see?
we generally don't accept them.
Okay.
But there's been a few people over time who didn't get along with us very well. Probably the most memorable of all of them was Jerry Seinfeld, who I
really?
Don't, yeah, he didn't like our show very much.
Ooh.
he wasn't a big fan. So that was an interesting interview.
It makes it awkward, doesn't it?
Yeah. I don't know if he was having a bad day or if he just really didn't appreciate what we did, but it was struggling through that one.
Now, you guys come on at 7?
Yes.
The morning mashup. Who's part
of
the mashup?
It's actually 6 a.m.
6.
6 to noon, Monday through Friday, and it's myself, Rich Davis, Nicole, and Stanley T. And it's been the four of us for, I think, 8 years now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And Nicole's expecting a baby, so congratulations to her.
Is she married or?
Oh yeah, yeah. She's married.
Okay,
yeah, she's married, and she's
guess which co-host is the dad? No, I'm just
kidding. That is the joke, but no, we know who the father is.
you guys have been together for 8 years, as you said. Who else is part of the channel? Because there's a lot of other voices that you hear, but I mean, it's primarily you guys.
Yes.
That get spread out. So you're on 6 to what time? Did
6
you say?
To noon.
6 to noon.
6 to noon.
And then you guys are filling in other roles and.
Yeah, well, our as I mentioned earlier, Kid Kelly, who's our boss, Kid's kind of a legend in the top 40 yeah. radio world. He has a syndicated show called Backtracks USA, which I believe airs around here, and he's done that, and he's an amazing teacher. I've never worked for somebody who expected so much from you. But the nice part is that you always get it back, is that whatever you give him, he finds a way to give back to you. So he's kind of the leader of the crew. And then Spider Harrison, who does our weekend countdown, Spider's been a guy that's around for a long time, has the most recognizable voice in the world.
Oh yeah.
And so he's in Miami though. He does everything from his house in Miami.
Oh really?
Yeah. And then Mikey Piff, our night guy, who's also our music director, and that's pretty much the crew.
Wow. We're talking with Ryan Sampson. He's on the Morning Mashup on Sirius XM's Hits 1 channel, which I think on the Sirius XM radio, it's Channel 2?
Channel 2.
Okay. And it's really confusing because it's the 40s on 4, the 50s on... No, I'm just kidding. we're going to bring in a guy who actually is in charge of selling vehicles
okay.
with your Sirius XM radios in them.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. Mike, are you going to pop on?
Sure.
Pull up a chair. This is Mike Young. He's going to join us here this morning because he's got to sell you. Is there an...
I don't need a chair.
You don't need a chair.
I can hide.
How are you? Nice to meet you.
So Mike's from Donovan Bauer Auto Group, and it's funny because you get into a car and you test drive, they've got Sirius XM, the demo on so you can hear it, and there's a couple voices you hear, yours.
Yes.
I've heard Sean Abbott, who is a guy from around here who does some production.
Yeah.
It's really incredible. And Mike, pretty much every car you have out there is...
Yeah, just about everything is Sirius equipped, and you get one free year. And this is the best view I've ever had.
Yeah. Kneel down.
No, I like
get a chair.
I'm not near as ugly.
What kind of
like
show
this?
Is turning into here?
I'm not near as ugly.
There you are.
Real professional here.
But, yeah, pretty much every car gets 1 year free subscription. And I would say probably 85% of our vehicles are equipped with Sirius. With the, through the Chrysler Dodge.
Yeah. Hey, Ryan, what's the talk around, headquarters there? I mean, viewer or listenership going up?
I mean, it's, as far as I know, since I've been there, it's, continually gone up. Those are the people that are way smarter than me. So I don't know a lot about that part. I pretty much just read about Justin Bieber.
Well, you guys are on like one of the most popular channels on there.
I honestly don't know. I know that, we get a good response when it comes to our Facebook and our Twitter and everything like that. But the one nice thing about working there is that we don't have to worry so much about that. Our focus is to go in and do a show and do the best one you can and not worry about the business side like that.
How big are the facilities? Are we talking multiple stories here?
Or? Yeah, we have our office is three floors in Rockefeller Center in New York. And then we have a warehouse in D.C. It's a massive warehouse in Washington, D.C., and there's also studios kind of popped around the country. There's a studio in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. There's one in Graceland. There's some studios up in Toronto. There's some stuff out in L.A. So there's, little places around. So it's a big operation. Not to mention, the people who deal with the car sales, and those are in different buildings. And then the rocket scientists who control the satellites are somewhere else. So it's a really big company.
What's that like waking up in the morning and walking through Rockefeller Center, seeing the big Christmas tree, and then waking up this morning and seeing our Christmas tree in Chatty Park? It's on the same level, right?
It actually is, believe it or not. No, they both have their charm. And I never thought I'd live in New York. And I every once in a while I have to stop and realize where I'm at and say, you live here. It's an amazing place to be.
That'd be incredible. Mike, you guys are open today and off the
we're
next couple
today.
Days.
We're open today. We're going to be closed Tuesday and Wednesday.
So you can test drive a vehicle.
Yep.
Turn on the Sirius XM satellite?
Yes, you can. And they're going to announce some bonus cash effective today. They haven't told us what it's on yet. So I know we're going to have some extra bonus cash between now and the end of the year.
Oh, wow.
On most of the lines.
Most of the lines. So get out. This is a good time to spend some of that extra money.
Yeah, we could use it.
All right, how late are you there today?
We'll be there till 8 o'clock.
Okay, close tomorrow and...
Close tomorrow and Wednesday, and then back open at 8 o'clock Thursday morning until 8 o'clock Thursday night.
All right. Hey, Mike, tell everybody Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody, and thanks for letting me on, Luke.
Hey, see ya. Take care.
Now if I can get up.
Just stay there the rest of the show.
You'll get old one of these days.
Merry Christmas. I think the other charm, Ryan, is you get to really know the listener. Like any radio station, you get to know the personalities and you develop a relationship with them. And when you guys are doing different segments throughout the day, it's really a family type atmosphere. And you guys shout out to Facebook friends.
Yes.
So you really build a nice solid listener base with that interaction.
The social media has been amazing. For radio, because you would have the request line back in the day and you would have three or four and you would try to get through as many and talk to as many people as you can, but it's limiting. But with Twitter or with Facebook, it's amazing how many people you can talk to in the course of a day. It's easy to do, and it's just made a world of difference as far as making friends with the people you know, who listen to you every day.
That's the best part of it.
Yeah, and that's the fun, you know, because you meet so many different people, and especially being national like this, you know, there's people from Canada, from all the way north in Canada, that they never see the sun. And then you get, you know, California people. And it, the mix of people you get and that you're able to talk to is a lot of fun.
I remember Todd Atkins told me very first couple days of working in radio, he's like, yeah, when people call for a request, you say, I'll see what I can do. That's the line. I'll see what I can do.
Well, and the thing is, what most people don't realize is they'll get upset that you don't play the request, but you had played it 5 minutes before they called. And that's right. What most people don't get.
Are you happy that you're in New York City? Is that where you're going to... Do you see yourself the rest of your career?
I'd like to. I mean, I have one day, as this business goes, they'll fire me and throw me to the street. So, you know, one day that'll happen, but I'd love to stay there as long as I can.
I just imagine, Mark, the personalities coming in and out of the building, the celebrities. You're kind of close to Howard Stern Studios?
Yeah, he's right down the hall. He's at the opposite end of the hall
from us.
Have
you ever seen him?
Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you see Howard, especially his crew. You know, you see Gary and Fred and Robin and, you know, Sal and Richard. You see these guys every day.
And Robin just came back, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah. So they've got, you know, they've got a really great operation. But I've, you know, I get to, one person that I really got to know a little bit is Cousin Brucey,
I grew up with him on ABC.
I share a studio with Cousin Brucey.
You do?
Yeah. Wow. So, you know, that's really cool he was in Grease. He was in, what's the Beatles musical that he was in? You can hear him in. But, you know, in that, meeting people like him was always really cool.
Have you found that radio has changed since you first started? And I know it's the little, you know, computers have changed, but what else has changed in radio?
It's the consolidation that's happened since I've gotten in the business has changed it, you know, a lot. When I first got into radio, you would have a standalone station. You know, you might have one station owned by one company and you were competing with everybody else. And that competition has always seemed to be gone now, where you're in a cluster with six other stations and they're your friends, whereas 10 years previously you were trying to beat the snot out of them.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, from where I started, the biggest difference in radio.
Do you ever get into any fights with some of the bigger New York terrestrial radio guys? Do they?
No, in fact, you know, they're actually very friendly, and I'm friends with a lot of these guys. So, you know, the old days of the radio battle aren't there anymore, which they were fun.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, they're just not there anymore.
There was a lot of heat, I mean, between either Imus and Stern or
Opie
Shan.
And Anthony. Yeah. It doesn't exist like that anymore. Everybody kind of plays in their own sandbox and leaves everybody else alone, which is good in some respects, but bumper stickering the competition's van was always fun.
Yeah, well, that's right.
You know, that
been there, done that.
Right. You know,
I think this was a couple years ago. Radio Inc. had a great article. It was, radio shouldn't be competition for radio because you end up making radio look bad, but radio's competition is, you know, TV and newspapers. And
sure. And, you know, I think you're competing with everybody. So the way that, you know, I've always some people take it very personally and will, you know, get in fights with people. And I never looked at it that way. You know, when I go to work, it's my job to beat you, but when we're done, I'm glad to buy you a beer.
Yeah.
You know, there's no need to take it to a personal level like that.
Yeah. Well, it was always interesting, too, because I think it was the bosses and the upper management always at odds. You'd show up at an event with another radio personality and it was like, hey,
yeah,
how are you?
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
How are things going? You know, all the trade secrets are out on the table. we're here again with Ryan Sampson, Sirius XM's Hits 1 channel, part of the morning mashup. What are you looking forward to doing here on your vacation?
It's seeing family and friends. You know, I try to get back 3 or 4 times a year, and it's just always great to be here. It's relaxing. I one day hope to be back here in some capacity.
Are you here for the week, a couple weeks?
I'm here till Thursday.
Thursday?
Yep.
And then back to New York?
Back to New York. And then I'm going to go up to Toronto for a couple days for New Year's.
You know, I saw a post where somebody was flagging you down to go up and visit them up there.
Yeah. That's where it's interesting is, you know, like you had mentioned the social media.
Yeah.
Is that, you know, strangers you have never met before are inviting you over to their house. Hey, you're going to be here. Come over. Okay. You know, and so I try to, you know, when I'm in a different town, I'll try to meet people out. And it's fun to, you know, be face to face with people, but sometimes you get offers that you're like, yeah, I want to live. <You're right. laughs> I don't know who you are.
My bodyguard's off duty right now. So you know, it's interesting living here in Northwest Pennsylvania. When you hear, you know, Sirius XM satellite radio, you think, is it going to be like my cell phone? Is the signal going to drop? It doesn't. I mean, places where you lose your phone, your connection is solid.
Yeah.
Solid. The technology is amazing. And it's neat to be able to listen to you here all the way to Erie or to Pittsburgh. And you don't have to worry about adjusting the dial.
Well, I think a lot of people, too, you know, the thing that I hear is that once you have it, you don't want to get rid of it. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's a little bit, it seems to me, you know, I don't have data, I'm not an expert in this, but it seems to me that it's a little bit like television. And you might have 300 channels, but there's five or six you primarily watch.
Yeah.
And, you know, you have your favorites and you stick with them. And having such a variety of channels, you know, allows you to find something different that you normally wouldn't hear on FM.
What do you listen to when you're not listening to yourself?
I'm a big fan of, I listen to the Outlaw Country station. I'm a big fan of the Joint, which is the reggae station. In some of the talk, I listen to Stern. You know, I cruise around the talk side. But those are my primary stations. Oh, and BPM, the dance station.
BPM.
Yeah.
You guys have some additional channels coming out for the new year. Dance party type of channels?
Yeah, they always do the kind of the specialty channels, mm-hmm. for either for holidays or, you know, if an artist has an album coming out. But they're frequent, you know, there's a lot of them. And I think that there's some, I think you're referring to some New Year's concerts,
yeah,
that are going to be broadcast.
Of the new songs out right now, which ones don't you mind listening to over and over?
You know what? I have no problem saying this, but I love the music I play. There's very frequently a song that I'll say that I absolutely hate. What is it? Hame right now,
mm-hmm.
is the one that I'm really loving. But I really enjoy, you know, the music that I play.
All right. My dirty secret, Ollie Murs.
Yeah.
Dance With Me Tonight. As catchy as heck, isn't it? Wow. How often are you rotating new music in?
Every week, we do music meetings every week where, you know, new stuff comes in, old stuff goes out, and even sometimes daily. You know, if something leaks or breaks, we'll work with it right then.
Wow. I guess when it comes to the terrestrial side of things, do you feel you guys can get a jump on incorporating newer music?
Simply because there's no commercials. You know, when you're not playing 16 minutes of commercials an hour, that's 16 more minutes of music. So it allows you to explore a little bit, which, you know, otherwise you wouldn't have that chance. The slots just aren't there.
Wow. Okay, outside of work, what do you do to relax?
I love walking around the city. I'm a people watcher, and I love to walk. So when I'm bored, I'll just, you know, hit the street and, and start walking and see where I end up.
Do you ever take a tape recorder with you just to...
No, I probably should, but no, I leave that at work.
Do you enjoy reading? Do you get a chance to do that? Are you so busy with work that...
I do. I read a lot of news articles. I'm not great with books, and I never have been, hence the non-academic nature of my college experience. But I read a lot of news articles, you know, and that's what I spend my day doing. I don't have the attention span to read anything more than 10 pages, so a lot of short articles.
What about movies?
My Netflix is busy. I'm actually more of a classic movie person. I'd rather, you know, watch a Cary Grant movie sometimes than...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Holiday Inn was on the other night, and the kids were just like, what is this?
I brought my daughter a collection of Marx Brothers.
Yeah.
And we just cracked up. I mean, she and I both like that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And she's in a film class, and she keeps saying, these people have never heard of this.
No. Yeah, which you know? that's where I always get confused, is where something that, you know, I grew up with. One of the great stories we like to joke about is we had an intern and asked her, oh, we need this fact about Hall & Oates. And she's like, I can't find anything about him. They don't exist, or he doesn't exist. And they're like, no, it's not Hall & Oates. She thought it was a person. Hall & Oates. It's an 80s group.
Which, by the way,
yes.
Have you ever watched Live from Daryl's House?
No.
That is really cool.
Reality show?
Well, Daryl has this huge house, I think, in Connecticut.
Okay.
And he invites musicians to come in and jam with them.
Oh, wow.
They'll do some Hall & Oates tunes, and they'll do something like, I'm trying to think, Smokey Robinson was in for an episode. They'll do some of Smokey's tunes.
Wow.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Yeah, I got to find that. I've never seen it.
Yeah, live from Daryl's house.
Okay.
It's really cool.
That's awesome.
Check it out. Ryan Sampson's joining us. Do you have a few more minutes, or do you have to take off? We're going to bring Emily Altamir in. She's the chamber director. We're going to take a quick timeout. We do have to take commercial breaks here. We'll take a quick timeout, bring Emily in to talk chamber. We'll wrap up the year with her, and Ryan will still be with us here as the morning drill continues on this Monday morning. The final show of the year, Mark, and I brought you some Kleenex just in case.
Thanks. Right. Love you too, sweetheart.
All right, we'll be right back. We'll also check that weather forecast. I think a white Christmas is on its way. We'll tell you all about it when the morning drill continues right after this.
Hold on, Santa. You may be the gift giver, but I'm the deal maker. 2013 Dodge Darts, up to $2,500 off sticker.
2013 Chrysler 200s, take up to $4,500 off sticker. 2013 Dodge Grand Caravan, take up to $4,200 off a sticker.
Or get zero APR for up to 72 months.
Merry Christmas from Donovan & Bauer Auto Group on Hightown Road in Titusville.
Booney Sports Bar on Diamond Street is your home for great food, big portion sizes, huge selection, and amazing service. From their award-winning wings to their mountain of fries and sides, Booney's offers the selection and the daily specials to keep you coming back for more. Dine in or carry out. Call in your order and it'll be ready in no time. Or dine in and enjoy their wide selection of beverages and weekly entertainment. So for great food, big portion sizes, huge selection, and amazing service, head on in to Booney Sports Bar on Diamond Street in Titusville.
Hi, I'm Phyllis Rapp, owner-designer here at Acorn Acres Floral Design. Acorn Acres has been voted best florist in the oil region for the past 6 years. Each design is created with the recipient in mind. Stop out or give us a call at 814-657-8599. For funeral, weddings, or everyday arrangements, contact us here at Acorn Acres Floral Design.
Bars Insurance in Titusville is dedicated to selling and servicing insurance to individuals and businesses in Oil City, Franklin, Titusville, and the entire state of Pennsylvania. Our commitment is to deliver solutions to our clients with professionalism and excellence. Our mission is to be the only resource for customers and consumers to consider when they purchase insurance. Contact Jason Biddish, your Bars Insurance Specialist today in Titusville. 827-7767. Bars Insurance, 204 West Spring Street, Titusville. Country Acres Personal Care Home provides their residents with the care that they have come to deserve. The caring staff attends to the needs of its residents, and the home provides spacious rooms and bathrooms. And now Country Acres offers adult daycare for those loved ones that need a little care during the day, while also providing respite care. For more information on Country Acres Personal Care Home, please call 827-3708 or visit them just past the airport on Route 27. Country Acres Personal Care Home. Wishing Alyssa, Titusville, and Maplewood the best of luck this sports season. Titusville chiropractor Adam Middleton welcomes you to the Titusville office of Middleton Chiropractic. Dr. Middleton is committed to improving the function of your nervous system so that you can have a higher quality of life. Through their office, you'll receive the best care through the use of modern chiropractic techniques and technology. Call us today and we can develop a chiropractic plan specific for you. 827-9970. Or visit our website for more information. Middleton Chiropractic, your chiropractor in Titusville.
Colonial Machine Company in Pleasantville is a proud supporter of the Titusville Rockets. The Colonial Machine Company takes pride in their products, working hard to manufacture and supply a quality product that's priced right and made right here in the USA. The Colonial Machine Company would like to wish the Rocket athletes best of luck on and off the field and remind you that you are a product of your school and the community. So continue to work hard, play hard, and maintain the quality of excellence that Rocket fans have come to expect. Go Rockets from the Colonial Machine Company in Pleasantville.
Zoom email users, your email has a great new look and some exciting new features. The enhancements include an improved web interface, more tools to keep you organized, and larger mailboxes. We've even added convenient links to your Facebook and Twitter accounts. The new look and upgraded features are designed to make your internet experience better than ever. For more information, visit armstrongmywire.com. Armstrong, one wire, infinite possibilities.
Flood warning in effect until 3:15 this afternoon. We'll take a look at that detailed forecast coming up in just a moment. Right now, Emily's joining us. Good morning, Emily. How are you?
Good morning, Luke. How are you?
Very good. Thank you. You've officially met Ryan?
I have.
Very
Shook
nice.
Hands and everything.
Wow, that's great. And of course, the jolly elf himself, Mark Heim, over there.
Oh, I'm a jolly something. I don't know if I'm an elf.
Yeah, Emily, we are getting ready to wrap up the year and kind of give us a score on how things went for you at the chamber over the last couple months.
So far, pretty smoothly. It's a sharp learning curve, but we're getting there, and the place is still standing, so that's good. We've got a few new members joining and some new momentum going into the new year. So
I could
excited.
See Sirius XM joining the Titusville Chamber.
I should talk to somebody about that.
Yeah, why not?
Now, just so you know, Emily, Ryan has interviewed thousands of celebrities and, and musicians, and he's going to grill you here this morning. Okay.
Excellent.
So any questions you have for Emily,
jump right in.
Just jump right in. Yeah. just pretend it's the morning mashup.
Are you done with your Christmas shopping?
Yes, and wrapping.
Really? See, I can't wrap anything. I'm an awful wrapper. I claim that I wrap things in the Bed Bath & Beyond paper.
Mike was just saying he wraps them in the U.S. Post Office paper.
Yeah, I wrap.
But that seems to be the big story this year, though, figuring out how to wrap your gifts. Everybody's offering gift wrapping or alternatives to gift wrapping.
What would be an alternative to gift wrapping?
Well, like the bags.
Yeah, okay.
Going to the stores, you know, let them put it in a bag with the tissue paper. And somebody the other day told me, it was yesterday. They said, put it in a bag and just staple it. I'm like,
that's pretty
I'll keep
classy.
That in mind.
The way I always thought of it is if you have to rip through it, it's wrapped. It might not have snowflakes, but you're ripping through it.
Yeah.
Well, we were just discussing this morning using the yellow pages, the comic pages. There were a couple of other things. I've seen people use wallpaper.
That's what I used to use on my books in school is I would use the comic strips for my books when I would make the book covers.
Sam Letzinger's wallpaper in his room?
Yes.
Ripping that down and
exactly.
wrapping.
Exactly. Using that.
A lot of alternatives there, yeah. So, Emily, what are you excited about in the new year with the Chamber?
There's so much that I haven't experienced even as a chamber member. So, for instance, the golf outing. I've never been to a single golf outing. So I'm going to master golf in the first 5 months of the year. And then I am looking forward to being there and taking part in that big event for the chamber.
Nobody really masters golf.
Oh, I'm pretty sure I can. It's all about your follow through. Right. Stance, grip.
Beer helps.
It'll be fine.
Yeah, beer helps.
The only way to get through. If everybody else has some, then my game
And then you just
improve.
Chase this little white ball around with a stick and swear at it.
Okay. I can do that. Or maybe I won't even try, so I have my beginner's luck will be fresh.
Okay. Now, the reverse raffle's coming up in what, February?
It is, yes.
February That's a fun night.
22nd, I believe. So, 100 tickets for sale. Make sure you get one of them for a chance to win $1,000 in cash, plus other side games of chance, raffles, winnings.
And all of this benefits the Chamber of Commerce, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
So that goes back into our kitty for all the other things we want to do throughout the year. So
now, are you to the point where you feel confident enough to start bringing in some of your ideas, or are you still trying to see how things go with these other events?
Well, that whole Home for the Holidays thing was a new thing I started. So I've already, checked off my first introduction. Yeah, so I don't think it's about confidence. It's more about finding the time and space between the calendar. We've got a little bit of open calendar to work with for, let's see, March, but then April is chamber month, so there's a lot. So it's sort of like, while March might seem quiet, it's because it's all getting ready for the multitude of activities for April, and then May getting ready for the golf outing in June. So
there's a lot of planning.
And then July,
time.
Slightly quiet to get ready for Oil Fest. So
you ride a roller coaster all year.
I think so. At least, and since it's still going to be the first year, and I'm getting adjusted and see how the schedule plays out. So I don't know if I want to mix it up too much while we're working on those big things, but we'll see.
Now, are the new board members being voted on right now, or when do they?
We're going to send the ballot out with the new January newsletter, so that's going to get mailed a week from today. So you should have that next week, and then we need votes in by, I believe it's the 17th. I think that's a Friday.
Now, Ryan, you're a member at large. Is that what you're going for?
I think so.
Okay. You can do that.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
$50. You can be a community member. You can come to all the meetings, all the open houses.
I'm going to have to Skype into the meetings.
That's fine. Okay. We can do that. Just be in touch. You get the newsletter. We send those all over.
I actually love getting mail from here. Whenever I get anything Titusville related, I'm extremely happy.
Do you get the alumni newsletter?
I do. I get the alumni newsletter, and I think I said this earlier that I'm always watching this show. I've always got it on the even though I'm doing my show, I've got yours in the corner. Read the newspaper every day.
How much show prep do you put in to the show?
Specific sit down and do it show prep, not a ton. Life is kind of show prep.
Yeah,
is the way we do it is that when we're I've always got to be paying attention. Whenever I overhear somebody in a restaurant or a store telling a story, I'll write it down, and change the names when it comes to doing it on the air. But life is kind of show prep is the way we look at it. So just always be paying attention. When you see something interesting, take a note so you don't forget it and bring it back up later.
See, there's our excuse.
Oh, that's right.
No, but we do a few hours every day. We when we were done with the show, we have meetings and we go over it and we do it. But I was never. I know some people are, and they would horribly disagree with me, especially that I was a program director for many years. But I've always believed life is more show prep than anything you can really sit down and plan.
And there's a lot going on in the world right now.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of topics to discuss. Emily, it's probably the same with you. It's every day's different for you. And you kind of take the feedback off the business people that you talk with or the community people. You go into a transportation meeting, and each time it's different. There's a different concern.
Yes. And I have not forgotten your request to look into the no right on red signs. We just haven't had a transportation meeting yet since you brought it up. But I'm on it. It's okay. In here.
You want them taken down?
Some of them, yeah.
I don't blame you.
We're going to get them all in her office.
Speaking of my office and the no right on red, that intersection is one of the places where you can still make a right on red.
Oh, that's good.
From Central onto Washington. And it's so nice because sometimes I'm sitting there and I'm like, wait a minute.
Go.
Go.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Well, it's just a couple spots. See what they did, Ryan, a couple years ago, we got all new street lights.
Okay.
And they went sign happy and put signs up everywhere. Yeah. So then the transportation committee said, well, if we vote, we can take some of those signs down, and they still haven't done that yet. No, the lights. How come the lights are still...
I don't know. Yeah, I get texts about that. I mean, I'm not, in charge of street lights. But, yeah, I heard that the Herald strobe light is back, so...
Yeah.
I saw that last night. We were trying
to figure... touch, right? Doesn't it make it seem like a big city?
Well, I was looking for the disco.
Just one guy doing this.
I think it's just one light now. A couple weeks ago, it was still two,
Yeah.
No, Em, you spent some time in New York City. Where are some places you enjoyed eating or just relaxing?
Relaxing. I don't know. Yeah, I lived in Midtown for 5 months straight, which no one lives in Midtown. So it's not meant to relax, and the food is bad because, for the most part, the food is bad because there are literally thousands of people going through every day, so you don't have to worry about return business. So you don't have to have good food because no one's going to complain. No one's ever going to eat there again anyway. So, like, there's some really bad stuff there.
Well, she's making the perfect point. Never eat in Times Square. If you go to New York, don't eat in Times Square.
What's the diner, though? The Stardust Diner.
Stardust Diner, where they sing.
Where they sing. That place is awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, that place isn't so bad.
It's awesome.
Well, and it's more of a sandwich and slice of pizza kind of environment. Though there was Dervish.
Yes.
I like Dervish. Chicken on a stick.
Okay. Now, which Ray's pizza is the Ray's pizza to go to?
The original Ray's. No, you know what?
You don't go.
Yeah. Well, there's Ray's. There's original Ray's. There's famous Ray's. There's original famous Ray's. And they really are what the original famous original or something is. The names get ridiculous. But I think it's a joke that there really isn't one. There really isn't one. I think it's just a joke.
But no, go ahead.
The pizza? My favorite pizza spot in New York is the L&B Spumoni Garden in Brooklyn. Ooh. Which is a Sicilian slice, but it's really good.
Now, where would you stack New York pizza compared to, like, Chicago? Or even, I hear California has, according to a survey, the best pizza.
Well, you can't put fish on a pizza. I mean, that's just wrong. I'm
just food in general. Yeah. Fish doesn't belong in your mouth.
But I'm strong in the New York court.
I eat fish just for the halibut. No, that's a bad joke.
Well done.
Bad
joke. I think that was perfect.
No.
Makes fun of me for the stupid things I say.
I know. See, it's
it's true, but everybody's being nice because it's Christmas. We're all getting along.
Are people nice in New York City this time of year?
Yeah. I think they're nice all...
Actually, New York isn't that bad.
No.
You brought up a really good point over the summer when I saw you.
Okay.
That New York is like a bunch of really small
towns. Yes.
So you get to know people. So it's not like stranger, but...
No, I live on the Upper West Side. So if you watch Seinfeld, or, you know, if you've seen You've Got Mail, that's my neighborhood. And I wouldn't have ever thought that when I moved to New York, I would know as many neighbors as I do. But I you know, I have my little block has a, you know, a community board, and they do two parties a year that they shut down the street, and one's a yard sale, and
oh, wow.
One's kind of, yeah, and one's, you know, just a little bit more of a block party. There's a planning party every year where everyone from the neighborhood comes out, and the planters around the trees, everyone plants flowers on my block, and so people get to know each other that way, and you go to the same businesses. So every, you know, just as if you're in Titusville, you have your dry cleaner or you have your restaurant, it's the same in your neighborhood. So you get to know, you know, that guy too. So New York is really, I've always felt it, a collection of small towns. There's just a lot of them.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Do you get a lot of movies shot in your block?
Yeah. Probably twice a month there's something filming.
Do you ever say, hey, can I have a bit part?
Well, what did I see? I try to walk through as often as I can. I was walking through, they were doing the Michael J. Fox show a couple weeks ago when I was walking through, and I got to see him. They filmed, if you know the movie The Warriors, my apartment is actually in The Warriors. Which
really?
Is,
yeah.
Which I love that. Where they're getting chased by the baseball furies, they run right by my apartment.
That's pretty cool. Emily, as a chamber director, what are you going to do to bring the movie business here to Titusville?
I think we should be able to capitalize on Pittsburgh's doing a lot, you know, so we got to just kind of lure them
actually,
this way
that is
with
a
all
good,
those incentives.
That is a good thought. Pittsburgh is really booming in the movie industry.
Couldn't the next Batman villain destroy something in Titusville? Or gazebo, perhaps? Yeah. It would be like... It would
Boy,
be
we're
like
picking on the gazebo Hines today, aren't we?
Oh, it would be like the Heinz Field scene, only instead of like the whole field being torn up, like the gazebo kind of splinters. Yeah, it'd be very dramatic. It's all about how you score it anyway, right?
Right.
The music.
Yep.
It's the music.
Some slow motion.
Yeah.
It looks amazing.
And the fog machine.
Emily, this time of year, what makes Christmas Christmas for you?
Christmas.
Sometimes it's a song, sometimes it's a movie, sometimes it's the people that you see. Not to get sappy here, but...
Yeah, you're really like going for a Barbara Walters moment, yeah. Aren't you? Church is an important part, so it's nice. I've been trying to make sure I get down to the Presbyterian church the last few weeks, so you get those, you know, the songs and the candlelight and... you know, the smell of pine and a little bit with the, like, shopping anxiety and baking. And there's, like, my dog has a little, like, flour dust on her shoulders because she's always, like, right under the counter as I'm, like, rolling out cookies. And I look at her, I'm like, what happened to you? Like, oh, because you flour and powdered sugar has fallen on her. Stuff like that.
Ryan?
It's definitely coming home and seeing people. Snow helps too. Snow helps.
We'll get that.
Yes.
I guess growing up here, what did you do around the holiday time when you were on Christmas vacation? What was the big thing to do? Was it going out to the country club and sled riding? I mean, what was...
That's one thing we did. Nothing that I can say that wouldn't get me rusty. No, there was a... You know, what I always loved about being here is we created... You know, I wasn't a big partier in high school, so it was, you know, create your own fun, which was...
I say that about high school all the time.
Yeah, and so we created our own fun. I think we used to play Capture the Flag with the pins at the country club. Is that we would go at 2 a.m. and take the pins and have giant games that capture the flag. Which that was always fun.
Now, Mark, how about for you? What is it for you?
It changes from year to year. Having helped to raise a big family and having gone through a lot of changes and what have you, Christmas is a little bit different every year. This year, it's getting to spend more time up at the living center where my brother lives. And actually enjoying the folks that I see on a regular basis up there. I've gotten to know the residents. I've gotten to know the folks that work there. We laugh and we cry over the Steelers games and stuff like that. And I find that there's a lot of stuff to talk about. So I'm really looking forward to that this week.
Ryan, are you a sports fan? Do you follow
the Steelers?
All right. I didn't know if they brainwashed you there. You're now a Jets fan.
No, that'll probably never happen.
We were in the city back in October, and I saw probably 10-1 Steelers jerseys over Jets. They were playing the Jets that weekend in New York.
There's a lot of New York fans, Jets and Giants fans, but the Steelers and the Cowboys have a big presence in New York. You know, and there's a couple good Steelers bars that I go to and watch the games at, so that makes it fun.
Excellent. Rex Ryan, is he on his way out?
I have no idea.
I don't care.
I don't care. I don't care.
Do you get into it with your mashup co-hosts?
Well, Rich, who's one of my co-hosts, also does a sports show on SNY, which is the sports television network in New York. So he's, him and I really like to... to get into it, but my opinion of or knowledge of sports is much less than him, so I pretty much just say things to annoy him, right. Which he takes it very personally, and I just egg him on.
Did you follow the Pirates this year?
Yeah, it was a great season to watch. I really wanted to go to one of the playoff games. There was the one game on a Sunday, and if they had done a day game, I was going to be able to go because I would have had to got back to work, but it wasn't, so I missed it.
Wow. You went to a couple Steelers games, right?
Just the one.
Just the one. Did you go to any Pirates games?
No, I don't really follow baseball. Like, we used to watch it when I was younger, and then after the baseball strike, it's like we all learned that we didn't need baseball, and it never returned. Yeah. So, yeah.
The one fan group that does stand out a little bit more are Penguins fans. If you go, you know, to a Jersey Devils game, there's usually more Pens fans there than Devils fans.
Wow. Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah,
that is so neat.
Yeah, that's actually fun. So I try to go, and now I'm going to have a third place because with the Islanders are moving into Brooklyn. So now, you know, in right there in New York City, there'll be three places to watch the Penguins, and that makes me happy.
Wow.
that's great.
Pretty cool. Yeah. So a little bit of home coming to you.
Exactly.
That's nice. Emily, you're going to be off for a couple days. When's the chamber officially closing up?
Tomorrow at noon. So come in and get your last-minute gift certificates. We'll be there all day today and tomorrow morning.
Lots of great Titusville things there. Books, sweatshirts, T-shirts.
Yes, some Historical Society stuff, too. Those oil barrel pens, you should come stock up.
I would actually love
that. Before you leave? Okay, there you go. I've got some
doing show prep with
his
oil barrel pen.
That's right. And you can tell everyone, and if you're Luke, you'll smell it, because Luke enjoys the petroleum smell of all things. It's on the outside now.
Yeah, you've got that little bottle right there. When we did, you know, everyone for a field trip went to Drake Well, and I drank one of those. Because they said that, you know, they used to use petroleum for medicine, and I'm like, oh, I bet you this will help. And I took a big swig of it, and it did quite the opposite.
Take it.
Thank you. Thank you. Probably will still make me sick. Oh, boy.
That's good, isn't it? It
smells like home.
I sit here after the show and just continue to smell that stuff.
Well, that's why there's a little missing. You've been inhaling a lot.
That explains a lot of things around here.
All right, and then you'll be back.
That's a great noise you made.
Yeah.
So
I'm
then
coughing too.
So we're closing tomorrow at noon, reopen 8:30 on Friday. And then Monday and Tuesday. I'm at a loss for when New Year's Eve is now, the day of the
Tuesday,
week it is.
Tuesday.
New Year's
yep.
Eve. Okay, so then yep. We'll be open again Monday to noon on Tuesday, closing early Tuesday, and then we'll reopen Thursday, 8:30. But no stream on Monday?
We are done for the year. Yeah. Done. Done. Ryan, are you back on the radio then for a couple days?
I'm actually on the radio right now. But yeah, so we run Best of shows when we're on vacation. I go back to work January 2nd.
January 2nd. Yeah. All right, see? We're all taking a break. It's good to step out, isn't it?
And one of the suggestions I heard last week was that the chamber should close between Christmas and New Year's. And I was like,
oh, really?
Maybe next year. It's hard with it being on a Wednesday. Like that's. I remembered when, like in school, that if you had Christmas on a Wednesday, that was the longest amount of time off you could have because of the way it fell and breaking up the weeks. But it makes it a little hard. Like I felt a little guilty if we closed too much. So.
Yeah. All right. So there's still an opportunity. A lot of people will have their Christmas family get-togethers after Christmas, just because people are coming in or whatever, so they could still stop in next week and
that's right.
get some
or
things.
This Friday, next Monday, if you need something, we'll be there. And also for your like tourist information, visitors guides, walking tour brochures, that kind of stuff. If you're in town looking for something to do, stop in. We'll help you out.
Okay. Real quick, Mark, what was probably the biggest story for you this year?
This year, wow. Well, in the area here locally, it was probably, and it's, you know, it's tough to pick because you try to look at things that are positive and there's always the things that are not. But I think the one that grabbed the most headlines was probably the shooting in July.
In Oil City.
And it did. It grabbed a lot of headlines. Maybe the best thing that came out of that was it did make a lot of people sit up and pay attention to what was going on. And it was a lot of people who don't normally sit up and pay attention to what's going on. And that was probably a good thing. And probably the biggest thing internationally, maybe, I mentioned it the other day when we were talking about that. I'm a big fan of Pope Francis, and I just thought it was so neat, you know, that we see someone like that in Rome for the first time from the New World. You know, it brings a fresh perspective. So
Ryan, for you, what was the biggest event of the year?
I think the most interesting kind of news story was Twinkies.
Yes, I've
never seen so many people freak out over a food item.
But they're back.
Yeah, they are back. They never left.
That could be the story that kind of got lost this year.
The Twinkie story.
The Twinkie story. Emily, a rough year. Outside of that, what comes to mind this year?
Well, starting the new job, I mean, that's going to really change...
New patients?
Change things for me, for sure, but hopefully change some things for a lot of people in our community in a positive way. So we'll hope to just keep looking up.
Well, very good. We wish you all the best, Emily, and it's going to be a great year, right?
Yep.
Absolutely. Hey, Ryan,
yes.
Thank you so much for stopping in.
This was great. I'm glad to finally be here. Like I said, I watch you every day, so I'm glad I could sit here and do it.
You know what we haven't done yet, and I don't know if you guys have to rush off, but we have to call our winner for the 12 Days of Christmas. We haven't done that yet.
Oh, yeah, we need to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you better take care of that.
Okay, so this is the 12 Days of Christmas contest. Let me pull this up. Today we're giving all the prizes, the rest of the prizes away, right? You guys don't care. Are you guys excited to do this? This is it. This is it for the
Yay!
Year. All right, we got to get the music ready. All right, here we go. 12 Days of Christmas. Hey, Adam, give the box to Ryan and Emily.
Uh-oh.
Faster, Adam, faster.
Faster.
Are you feeling
faster,
better?
Faster.
You've been out sick for a while.
All right, Ryan, go ahead. Reach in.
We're picking a name?
Picking a name.
Hold on, I'm going all the way to the bottom.
Yeah, don't... Don't share the phone number. Yeah, Adam, grab the... Is it legit? We had some people from the bars write some pretty funny names.
I believe it is.
All right.
Look. It's not a name I recognize.
All right, Adam, you want to bring that over?
You always got to like say it out loud in your head a few times. You're like, is this thing we can say? I think it's all right.
Where you're thinking, I can't believe.
All right, we are giving away today, what do we have? A $25 Sheetz gift card, $25 True Value gift card, free income tax preparation from Liberty Tax Service, $25 gift card from Perk Place, Bayless Fuel, Landmark Square, Primitive Sentiments, Warner's Bakery, a t-shirt from Big Kahuna's. We should have had you bring something and autograph it. Do you have a picture of yourself?
Yeah, we can send those. I probably could get someone a little more famous than...
No. You're the Titusville guy.
Hello.
All right, this guy's not here. All right, we got to draw another name.
Another? It's your turn.
There you go. A lot altogether. Okay. That seems also legit.
It seems legit. Thanks,
Adam. How often do you have to go through like 20 names before you get somebody who's awake?
This week's been okay, but we've had times where it's been a pain. We might be here till 11, by the way. Okay.
Hello?
Hello, is Judy available?
No, she went to see a friend.
Oh, well, who's this?
This is Bart.
Well, this is Luke and Mark and Ryan and Emily from the Morning Drill this morning. We just pulled Judy's name in our 12 Days of Christmas contest. She's our winner this morning.
Okay.
Very good. Well, listen, Judy won a $25 Sheetz gift card, a $25 True Value gift card, free tax preparation from Liberty Tax Service, $25 gift card for Perk Place Cafe, Bayless Fuel Service in Titusville, Landmark Square, Primitive Sediments, Warner's Bakery, and a t-shirt from Big Kahuna's. Now, you got to be excited about that.
Okay.
All right. Can we ask you just a couple holiday questions first?
All right.
All right. You guys might be able to help out here.
Okay.
Who did Jimmy Boyd see his mommy kissing in 1952?
Santa Claus.
That is correct. That was the first correct answer we've ever had. Let's see. In Sweden, a common Christmas decoration is a small figurine of a goat made from what? Shortbread, straw, or silver?
Shortbread.
Did you say a straw?
I guess that's what I was supposed to say.
Right. Hey, congratulations. You're the winner, or Judy's the winner this morning. Now, you can come by and get your prizes by visiting our studio. We're on the second floor of Farmers National Bank in Titusville. Okay?
Okay. Second floor of Farmers.
Yes, and we're going to be here till about 3 o'clock today, and then we'll be here Friday.
Okay, 3 today and all day Friday?
Yeah. All right?
Okay.
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, so it took two callers. Not too bad. Not too bad.
Very good.
All righty, guys. Any last thoughts before we wrap things up?
Merry Christmas?
Merry Christmas.
That's about it.
Ho, ho, ho. I guess.
All righty. Mark, have a great couple weeks. You'll be around here a little bit.
Yeah, I'll be here. I'll be in and around and off and on and what have you. You have a good Christmas with your family as well.
Yes, I'll try to. Ryan, you get to see some of your family members this week?
Yep, I do. My parents will be in from Baltimore later today. Most of my family's here, so this is great.
Great. And is it sort of hit or miss when you come back during the year, or are there planned times you come back?
I usually Christmas, Thanksgiving, and Memorial Day are usually pretty set in stone.
Solid.
Yeah. But I try to get a couple more in the middle.
Very good. Well, when you come back, please stop back.
I would love to. This was fun.
Great. Well, thank you for being here. Emily, always a pleasure.
Likewise.
We're looking forward to a brand new year.
That's right.
And the Chamber continuing to do great things. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, Mike, Carol.
The other guy, Adam.
Thanks. Hey, we'll see you next year. January 6th, we'll be back. And, of course, Mark will keep things updated on the website a couple times between now and then, right?
Through Through the period, yes.
Through the period. Yes. By the way, we're covering a lot of the Christmas Eve services at the Presbyterian Church, the Methodist Church, and at Community Bible Church tomorrow night. So we'll have those available on our website probably by the end of the week. All righty. Merry Christmas, everyone. See you next year.
Originating from the birthplace of the oil industry, we are the stream.